It's been 9 days of bug fixing. I mean, I call it bug fixing, but a lot of it's unquantifiable things like this feels a bit boring or this bit of menu isn't very easy to read. So it's not that our code is so bad that everything's broken, it's that we need to polish every feature so that it's understandable. So finally, I'm onto the Switch version and I'm adding a new mode. Arcade mode. There's nothing there except this menu, you know. But I'm showing the game in Korea this week at a public show. So I think like 10,000 people go to that Busan Indie Connect. And I guess I'd rather show it on console because I think showing a game on a phone, and it's quite a slow-paced game, it's not like the best way to introduce like players. It's an indie game event, and I think phone games probably are looked down on in indie game events, so that's why I want to get the Switch one working. I'm supposed to be showing Pixo Cities, but it doesn't work, so I've got 2 days to try and get that working. That's not probably going to happen. Anyway, yeah, so one of the things that took a really long time was fixing the aspect ratio. So for the phone versus like an iPad, so an iPad's like a 4:3 ratio, and your phone is 21:9 if you have something like an Xperia. So the difference is really crazy, and some of the bits of UI that you design don't even fit on the screen anymore. So you have to sort of compromise the look of things a little bit here and there. But in general, I think the game's coming together. We think that tomorrow we might actually have a pretty close to release candidate for the mobile. So we have a new shuffle mode, shuffle thing, because the game's a bit slow and you're kind of waiting. So Cindy suggested adding a shuffle button, and it's really made the game a lot more snappy. Yeah, so we're up to 465 hours of development. That's because a lot more people are now working on the game, polishing it, playing it, giving feedback, trying to kind of figure out how we can make every last bit really awesome. So speedrunning game dev, I don't think 500 hours is really speedrunning, but I guess it's the best we can do.